Gen Z.
Trying to be a teenager and a mum at the same time is pretty hard because I'm mostly in the house with Kenzie until it's bedtime.
I would like her to bond better with Kenzie. I really would. Becky still hankers after this. I want my old life back.
You got a kiss, Banana?
No.
You're tight with your kisses, aren't you?
16-year-old Becky is mum to 14-month-old Kenzie.
I was 15 years old when I got pregnant. I was planning to have my first baby when I was 23. And when I found out I was pregnant, I thought, oh no, my life's over.
No, you're not getting my cup of tea.
Becky and Kenzie live in Fife with her mum Trish and 10-year-old brother George.
Banana spoiled boy.
There was rumours going around that Becky might be pregnant. Of course, I questioned Becky when she came in from school, and she denied it.
She was determined that she was going to get it out of me by asking me, do you want to tell me anything? Is there anything important you want to tell me? And I was like, no, there's nothing.
Eventually, after about half an hour, she admitted it, and I flew into a rage. The argument got so bad with the shouting and the screaming at each other that she called the police on me. She wanted me lifted.
It was Kenzie's, well, my first scan. I can see his ribs and his head. Being a mum is good, but it's stressful as well. It just stops you from doing a lot of things that you used to do. My life used to be, like, fun. Picture of Kenzie. I didn't think about condoms or nothing. I was just having fun. I just thought, I'll not get pregnant anyway, so what's the point?
Becky was with her boyfriend for a month when she fell pregnant.
I met Kenzie's dad, and then we just kind of got together, got drunk and stuff that teenagers do. But then a couple of weeks later, I found out I was pregnant.
Throughout her pregnancy and after the birth, the couple were on and off. But before they'd had a chance to work things out, Kenzie's dad was gone from their lives.
I have never met, and unfortunately will never meet, Kenzie's dad. Unfortunately died last year in a tragic accident.
Kenzie was 7 months old when his 16-year-old dad died suddenly in his sleep.
4 days before he passed away, he got me on my knees and he cuddled me and he says, I love you. And tell Kenzie I love him too and give him a cuddle and a kiss from me. And that was the last time I seen or heard from him. Well, there's Kenzie's dad's Facebook. I've put, there's your wee boy, he's getting a lot like you now. He can say daddy now. And then I said, why did you have to go? It wasn't your time, not now, not ever. I miss you loads now. He was my first sexual partner, so I felt him as special. And he's still special.
Losing Kenzie's dad so soon after the birth has had an impact on her relationship with her son.
Becky's attitude towards Kenzie at one stage was, don't want you anymore because your dad's not here and I'm stuck with a reminder of him.
Kenzie, pack it in!
There are days, and there seems to be more and more of them, that Becky could quite easily live without Kenzie.
Kenzie!
I tried to help Becky bond with Kenzie by trying to leave them alone, but that can be quite hard as well because she finds it very difficult to cope with him.
Fifteen-year-old Davita is expecting a baby girl in just 4 weeks.
I was 14 when I got pregnant. At first, when I started getting a bump, I was quite embarrassed because people was just taking it that I was a slag and I'd slept around with loads of people. But the baby's dad was the first person I slept with.
I only slept with him once. That was my 21-week skin when I found out what I was having. When I found out I was having a girl, I was real happy. I'm calling her Kayla.
Davita lives in Morecambe with her mum Jackie and older brother.
Finding out that your 14-year-old daughter is pregnant, oh, it's a huge thing to cope with. It's a huge thing. The first 2 weeks, I think I just cried my way through the first 2 weeks. I felt heartbroken. I just looked at her, and every time I looked at her, I thought, she's only 14. In a way, I felt a bit like grieving. I'd lost my little girl. Even now I look at Davita and I think it's a child within a child.
In this difficult time, Jackie has turned to her local church for support.
Going to church is an important part of our lives. It has been through my children's upbringing.
Davita was baptised when she was 12, and she too finds comfort in the church.
Church has been quite a big support at times. If you're going through a sad stage or something, if you go to church, then you can talk to people about it and just, like, get all your emotions out and you feel much better.
I did ask our minister to announce that Davita was pregnant in church, that everybody knew what was happening. I feel that God is not going to condemn anybody because you've made this decision to keep this baby or not keep this baby, or even to have sex when you're not married. It doesn't mean it's okay, but we all make mistakes and we have to live with them in the best way that we can.
But the whole sex before marriage thing, it's not really brought up much in our church. It's people's decisions if they want to. People don't go against you if you decide not to.
This is Davita's favourite meal at the moment. Often tend to do whatever it is that Davita wants. She is a bit spoiled. Davita, did you want to come and take these plates in then, please?
Davita is now spending most of her time at home with her mum.
I miss being at school for the fact that I don't get to see my friends as much. Some days during the week I go to the children's centre, but if I'm not doing anything then I'll just sit at home and watch telly. I spend most of my time with my mum at the moment.
I'm not scared yet, no. I will be my heart's break.
As well as her mum, Davita sees one other friend regularly, fellow mum-to-be, 17-year-old Tara.
I think I'm more excited, but yeah. When it happens I'll be like, oh, yeah. It's happening now.
Are you ever on your own?
I don't like to be now, do I?
No, I'm never too far away, so I can be available at any time, really.
With Davita, she likes to know that I'm somewhere nearby, that she can get in touch with me and that I can be there ASAP. So, you know, as long as she knows Mum's somewhere nearby, she's okay.
The biggest part of my life is my mum. Before I got pregnant, me and my mum were close, but not as close as we are now. We do everything together, and I tell her absolutely everything.
In Fife, 16-year-old Becky is having problems adapting to life with a 14-month-old child.
Can you help her?
Do you want me to?
Go on then. Right, is Jamie's after here?
Without my mum, I probably wouldn't be able to survive, as she helps me with everything.
You gonna take your shirt off?
I prefer her to help me, because that way I don't get stressed and angry.
Where's mum gone? She disappeared at the crucial point again. And gets Nana to do it.
I remember her coming through to my room at about 3 o'clock one morning, throwing him on the bed, saying, you deal with him, I can't do this anymore. And he was less than 2 weeks old.
What are you wanting for your tea, George?
I feel like a mum to all three of them, because Becky's always coming to me and saying, oh, mum, will you do that with him, and would you get him out of my hair? And it's just like I'm separating siblings rather than a mother and her son.
He's your boy. You feed him.
She's only just realising that he's here for the rest of her life and his life.
You happy?
No.
What do you mean, no? Not night, Kenzie.
Well, this time of the night, when Kenzie goes to bed, it's my time of the night. I can't wait till it comes. Because then we both got a rest and get peace and quiet from each other. Like, do what I want. Night, Kenzie.
Becky goes to college one afternoon a week. The rest of the time, she's either at home or helping her mum at work.
I have a small cleaning business, and Becky comes with me on days that are usually quite busy.
Bye, Kenzie. 2 minutes.
I go to work with mum when I can be bothered, but half time she drags me out my bed because she doesn't want me on the couch all day.
So that Becky doesn't feel too overwhelmed, Kenzie goes to a childminder 5 days a week, paid for with tax credits and topped up by Tricia.
She gets paid for him if he's there or not, so wasting the money if he's not down there.
Would you like to have Kenzie during the day?
No, I like my peace and quiet.
During the week, she doesn't really have Kenzie very much because she can't handle Kenzie very well on her own. Kenzie would do her head in by the end of the week.
Over the past year, Becky has suffered from depression on and off. Mum Tricia wants to make sure she doesn't go down that path again.
You have to get you sorted. Because once you're sorted, you might be a little bit happier about yourself. You end up shouting at Kenzie and shouting at me and...
No, I don't.
If you had something to look forward to and to focus on, you might be a lot happier. No?
No.
But I'm not going to have you sitting on the settee doing absolutely nothing all day watching the telly. But you had big ideas when you were younger.
Like working on a pub in Spain.
You wanted to run your own bar. That's quite an ambition. If you can't do one thing, then you need to...
I want to be a midwife. I want to see it from the other end.
But if you want to be a midwife, great.
Becky missed her GCSEs because of her pregnancy and has to do a catch-up class before she can move on.
I'm feeling stressed, sad, angry. It's really, really boring. And it's like you've learnt that thing in high school and then you go up to the college and it's like I've already learnt that. And they're like, well, you have to learn it again. I want to get stuck into midwifery. I want to be able to wake up in the morning and think, right, college today.
I just want to see you happy.
Back in Morecambe, 15-year-old Davita is 37 weeks pregnant and going to see her midwife.
Thank you. What a mum's for, Davita.
The father of Davita's baby is not around, so Mum Jackie goes with her to all her antenatal appointments.
So we'll just have a check. Oh, that head's well fixed down there now. The baby's in the right position for you to go into labour. That's brilliant. Good. Okay.
Me and the baby's dad don't talk at all anymore. I didn't really know him at all when we first got together. It was just I wanted a boyfriend and he liked me, so...
It can happen any time now, can't it?
Who are you going to have with you when you go into labour?
My mum.
Okay.
It was really upsetting knowing the baby's not going to have a dad around her and knowing that, like, my first child isn't going to be a proper family and things.
Putting fresh toilet rolls in toilets. They all seem to have been used up this week. It must have been a busy week.
Davita has a Saturday cleaning job at the church, but is finding it hard now she's so pregnant.
Because I've been having problems, like, walking and stuff. My mum does literally everything for me.
I think I'm a bit of a soft mum at times. Because she is the youngest, there isn't anybody else to take my full attention. So she gets all the attention at the moment, mostly. Sometimes things feel a bit much and feels everything bogs you down, but then you have to get back up again and just get back in there. So, what are we going to do next?
I'm not good.
As well as doing Davita's job, Jackie has two jobs of her own to make ends meet.
I'm a school travel assistant, which I really enjoy doing. And then I also do paper deliveries. I just seem to have a very busy life. And it won't be long before it's going to get busier again with baby around. So we just get on and deal with things, get on with it.
Dada!
Oh, Dada's on here. Come here.
In Scotland, 16-year-old mum Becky has been single since her baby's dad died 8 months ago and is finding Kenzie a constant reminder of her ex.
Bye-bye. Sometimes he shouts dad as he's walking up the stairs. He does it all the time.
Come catch George.
And just randomly come up with dad. And it's like, no, Kenzie, dad's not here no more. He's singing with angels. And he just looks at me like I'm confused.
He's the Iron Brew man.
No, that's how you've got orange hair.
Today, Trisha's car has broken down, so they can't go to work or college, and Kenzie can't go to the childminder, so they're all stuck at home.
Becky, Kenzie's just going to stay here today.
Oh, no, he's not. Why is he staying here?
By 9 o'clock, Becky wants to get out of the house.
Well, I'll walk George to school.
Yeah, you can walk George to school if you want.
I won't be long. Right, bye.
Bye.
I don't normally take George to school, but I'm enjoying the day because I need out of the house. Right, bye.
Bye.
I'm in the house all the time. It's boring. Not to do in the house. When I lost Kenzie's dad, I wouldn't go near Kenzie, pick him up, bath him. I wouldn't do anything at all with him. I was mostly depressed because I didn't have, like, a dad figure for Kenzie.
Get in. Now.
I was scared that I would be a single parent, and I am a single parent.
I said no.
I like to have somebody to love me as well as my son. I want to be free of us.
My own little time with him was great. It was absolutely great.
Day more often then?
I can't, because I'm always working.
Well, my dad always have them.
Yeah. It's your boy.
I worry about them constantly. I worry about her attitude towards him sometimes. There's quite a lot of resentment there, or what appears to be resentment. She doesn't want to be burdened with him. It's quite easy for her to walk away in the house.
I think it's going to be tea and bath and bed for you. Is that why Mum went out? See?
Oh, my God.
Mum? Was it this?
The next morning, things are looking up for Becky.
I can't wait.
Are you happy now?
Yeah.
It's all right then.
She's just got a text from a boy she met recently.
Yeah, I'm going on a date. It's first proper date since Kenzie's been born. I'd love Kenzie to have, like, a stepdad, but a dad figure, somebody to look up to, and I just feel like he's going to be there. I think we're going to be happy.
In Morecambe, 15-year-old Davita is about to become a mum.
Yeah, it's a lot. And it is really uncomfortable.
It hasn't been an easy start to her labour.
I've been here about 18 hours. I'm only 2 days over my due date. But because I've got, like, high blood pressure and protein, they've had to induce me.
In the absence of a boyfriend, Jackie is the natural stand-in.
It is a bit strange because I'm a mother, I'm baby's grandma, I'm also a partner. So I'm a bit of everything, really. But it's lovely to be going through all this with her, to be able to be there for her.
Right, do we want to close this curtain off then?
The birth isn't moving along as quickly as the doctors would like, so she is given a second induction pill internally.
I just need you to relax your bottom down. Yeah.
It's important to relax. It makes it easier and gets it over with quicker.
Deep breath. Keep breathing like that. I've got to just get this in right behind the baby's head.
Go out. I know. Stun.
Davita has been at the hospital for 27 hours and finally her contractions have started.
It's a lot. I'm tired.
Having very strong contractions now and very close together. So they're going to break her waters, which is going to be a big thing for her, but it means we're getting in the final stages. And she'll soon have her own little baby and this will all be over, won't it? I'm feeling very emotional at the moment. And I'm feeling very proud of her. She's fantastic, yeah. You're wonderful.
I'm going to start to push now. She's wanting to push. So we'll soon have a baby for you to see.
£7.12. An hour after her contractions start, Davita gives birth to a healthy little girl.
This is Kayla Marie, and she arrived at 4 minutes past 11.
Put the monitor on.
In Scotland, a month has gone by and Becky is still single after her date fell through.
Oh,
yeah.
Missus.
Mum Tricia is trying to lift Becky's spirits and help her bond with Kenzie, but at the moment she is refusing to take him out of the house on her own.
It must be boring for Kenzie being here every weekend as well. You know, it's the same boring routine for him as well as for you.
There's nothing to do.
You've got that play zone card. It gives you somewhere to go.
Mm.
Other than that, head towards the beach for the day.
Even beach is full of stones and litter.
What about further along?
Big rocks.
Is it? Do you not fancy the mother and baby group up at the church?
No way.
Do you know anybody that's been?
The other lass that goes to college, she went and she said they're all in their 30s.
Do they not talk to her about things?
No.
Biggie's always had an excuse for things, and they weren't reasonable excuses. I just wanted to go out and do things with Kenzie and be a mum. I think it's mainly confidence issues with Becky. She's hit rock bottom just now. You're not gonna go to the park or something for a wee while with them?
Yeah. The next day, Becky and Mum are back from work. Trisha finally persuades Becky to get out of the house with Kenzie.
Oh, well, she's gonna have to go out, aren't I?
Kenzie? Are we going down there to throw some stones? Out of the water?
I don't mind taking Kenzie out on my own. I just prefer company because it's only pushing a pram.
Is that a nice one?
Kenzie doesn't talk much, and if he has a feed before he goes out, he'll sleep in his pram. And it's like I'm talking to myself.
What is that? Mum, are you bringing him up? Mum!
Sorry, I'll just calm down myself.
After a stressful 20 minutes, Becky and Kenzie are back at home.
Give me that.
You need a hand?
No, Kenzie.
Are you all right?
Yes.
What's wrong?
Well, I'm kind of tired myself, Mum.
Yeah, well, everybody is, Becky. It's what it's like being a mum.
It's not that. You should have been in his bed ages ago.
And it won't do him any harm. It should have been an enjoyable evening, and it was nothing like that. She just came back in a bad mood, slamping and banging around. Getting Kenzie a way out of her sight as quickly as possible.
Can I go and have a fag?
Two?
Can I go and have a fag? Uh-huh. I feel like I need a break from everything. The house and my family and Kenzie.
Night-night, wee man.
Night-night.
Are you just grumpy because you're tired?
No, I'm bored.
But you were out.
Aye, I know, but what am I supposed to do the rest of the night?
But there's nothing stopping you going out.
Woohoo, that's what I'm saying. And my pals don't want to know me no more.
And why don't they want to know you?
Because I got a bearing.
You did know that some people would walk away, that they're not your true friends.
Aye, well, they've all walked away, so...
You feel that you've been abandoned because you've had Kenzie, but it's not his fault. You can't...
It's the same with guys, though. Every time I meet a new guy, I have to tell them that I've got a bearing.
You don't have
like
to tell
it,
them.
If I like it or not, well, they're going to find out, aren't they? Why you got a cot in your bedroom? Why you got a screaming bearing in your bedroom? Oh, that's mine. But there's nothing I can do.
So I'm not going to keep on at you, Becky, because I can see you're tired and I can see you're upset about something.
I'm not upset about anything.
Davita's baby Kayla is now 8 weeks old, and the 15-year-old mum is settling into her new life. She's feeling confident enough to be out and about with her baby and is meeting up with fellow teen mums, Tara and Maureen.
Look at his hair now.
He's got little...
It was blonde, wasn't it?
We were together just about all the time during pregnancy. If I wasn't actually there, I was somewhere very nearby. Just felt like she was totally dependent on me. And as much as I love her, it was getting where it felt a lot of strain on me.
How do you explain labour?
I describe it as a bowling ball without your mum.
The relationship with my mum was still close, but now I like to do my own thing and I feel a lot more independent now. Having a baby is harder than what I thought it would be. I find it hard breastfeeding her because I can't, like, ask someone else to feed her if I'm really tired or... It is nice having that bond with her, though.
Yeah. Her attitude towards everything is a lot more grown up. She is much more confident. Now the next stage is for her to get back to school, which she really wants to be able to do her GCSEs. She wants to be able to do as best as she can. She's just fantastic.
But you have to think of things from, like, a different view, don't you?
Yeah.
I do believe that God is there, that he does help us, guide us through things, to help to give us the strength to cope with things. And sometimes you need a lot of strength to get through life. I think I have been given a lot of strength to be able to cope with everything.
Now she's here, I wouldn't
change her for the world, but if I could have gone back and waited a couple of years, I would have, because it's really hard. You don't actually understand how hard it is until we're here. Yeah, I do.
I am so proud of them. It makes me feel quite emotional. I just think she's been amazing throughout everything.
Up in Scotland, there have been some big changes for Becky.
Hey, Kenzie, you going to shop and all that?
We can get you ready.
4 weeks ago, she met 17-year-old Sean on the internet, and he's already moved in.
We were only mates, but I decided just to dig a little bit further. Sean's living here because he got kicked out and he just needed a place to stay. It's been about 3 weeks now. The first time I saw him, I thought he was one. And then weeks later, he was mine. I was like, is this a dream?
Cheers, Sean. Cheers.
Becky seems happier now that she's got somebody in her life, a boyfriend.
Oh, you're disgusting.
He keeps her spirits up when she goes a wee bit down.
Come here.
Becky has recently knuckled down at college and is even making concrete plans for her future.
Becky's just got onto the midwifery course at college. It's only for an extra day per week, but gradually it'll build up and finally kick off her nursing career.
Becky's career plans and new love life have had a knock-on effect to her and Kenzie's relationship.
Okay. Sean likes Kenzie and it's like we do things together and it's just great fun.
She has been out more with Kenzie. Sean likes to be out and about and he's often said, oh, come on, Becky, let's go. And they have. Maybe not been out for very long, but it's a start.
Before, my mum used to help me a lot with Kenzie. Now it's like she makes his tea and I put him in the bath and I feed him and put him to bed. I do all of that now.
I still worry about Becky and Kenzie, but I can see that they're getting stronger together as a mum and a son.
Oh, bye, Sky. Me and Kenzie have got our own love together. Feels great. Because if you didn't have a boyfriend, then you always go to sleep thinking that there is somebody that loves you and you love them back. I used to cry myself to sleep, but now that I've got Sean in the bed with me and Kenzie's at the bottom of the room, I go to sleep happy. And I dream about happy things instead of sad, scary things now. Just feel happy.
Pink baby Adidas trainers.
Next time, we meet Abby from Hampshire.
It does make me sound like I was shagging about, but I wasn't. I was just trying to get back at this boy.
Abby wasn't sure who the father of the baby was. It's any mum's nightmare.
I can't go physically go, Mum.
Next on 3, Cherry meets women of all shapes and sizes to find out what makes a body beautiful. Same time tomorrow, the brilliant Jono faces his future fears in So What If My Baby Is Born Like Me. And Wednesday night is film night on 3, so get your TV dinner ready in time for Good Will Hunting at 9.
Kenzie.
Trying to be a teenager and a mum at the same time is pretty hard because I'm mostly in the house with Kenzie until it's bedtime.
I would like her to bond better with Kenzie. I really would. Becky still hankers after this. I want my old life back.
You got a kiss for Nana?
No.
You're tight with your kisses, aren't you?
16-year-old Becky is mum to 14-month-old Kenzie.
I was 15 years old when I got pregnant. I was planning to have my first baby when I was 23. And when I found out I was pregnant, I thought, oh no, my life's over.
No, you're not getting my cup of tea.
Becky and Kenzie live in Fife with her mum Trish and 10-year-old brother George.
The Nana's spoiled boy.
There was rumours going around that Becky might be pregnant. Of course, I questioned Becky when she came in from school. And she denied it.
She was determined that she was going to get it out of me,
by asking me, do you want to tell me anything? Is there anything important you want to tell me? And I was like, no, there's nothing.
Eventually, after about half an hour, she admitted it, and I flew into a rage. The argument got so bad with the shouting and the screaming at each other that she called the police on me. She wanted me lifted.
Kenzie's, well, my first scan. I can see his ribs and his head. Being a mum is good, but it's stressful as well. It just stops you from doing a lot of things that you used to do. My life used to be, like, fun.
Picture of Kenzie.
I didn't think about condoms or nothing. I was just having fun. I just thought, I'll not get pregnant anyway, so what's the point?
Becky was with her boyfriend for a month when she fell pregnant.
I met Kenzie's dad, and then we just kind of got together, got drunk and stuff that teenagers do. But then a couple of weeks later, I found out I was pregnant.
Throughout her pregnancy and after the birth, the couple were on and off. But before they'd had a chance to work things out, Kenzie's dad was gone from their lives.
I have never met, and unfortunately will never meet, Kenzie's dad. Unfortunately, he died last year in a tragic accident.
Kenzie was 7 months old when his 16-year-old dad died suddenly in his sleep.
4 days before he passed away, he got me on my knees and he cuddled me and he says, I love you. And tell Kenzie I love him too and give him a cuddle and a kiss from me. And that was the last time I seen or heard from him.
Well, there's Kenzie's dad's Facebook. I've put, there's your wee boy, he's getting a lot like you now. He can say daddy now. And then I said, why did you have to go? It wasn't your time, not now, not ever. I miss you loads now.
He was my first sexual partner, so I felt him as special, and he's still special.
Losing Kenzie's dad so soon after the birth has had an impact on her relationship with her son.
Becky's attitude towards Kenzie at one stage was, don't want you anymore because your dad's not here and I'm stuck with a reminder of him.
Kenzie, pack it in!
There are days, and there seems to be more and more of them, that Becky could quite easily live without Kenzie.
Kenzie!
I tried to help Becky bond with Kenzie by trying to leave them alone, but that can be quite hard as well because she finds it very difficult to cope with them.
Fifteen-year-old Davita is expecting a baby girl in just 4 weeks.
I was 14 when I got pregnant. At first, when I started getting a bump, I was quite embarrassed because people was just taking it that I was a slag and I'd slept around with loads of people. But the baby's dad was the first person I slept with.
I only slept with him once. That was my 21-week skin when I found out what I was having. When I found out I was having a girl, I was real happy. I'm calling her Kayla.
Davita lives in Morecambe with her mum Jackie and older brother.
Finding out that your 14-year-old daughter is pregnant, oh, it's a huge thing to cope with. It's a huge thing. The first 2 weeks, I think I just cried my way through the first 2 weeks. I felt heartbroken. I just looked at her, and every time I looked at her, I thought, she's only 14. In a way, it felt a bit like grieving. I'd lost my little girl. Even now I look at Davita and I think it's a child within a child.
In this difficult time, Jackie has turned to her local church for support.
Going to church is an important part of our lives. It has been through my children's upbringing.
Davita was baptised when she was 12 and she too finds comfort in the church.
Church has been quite a big support at times. If you're going through a sad stage or something, if you go to church, then you can talk to people about it and just, like, get all your emotions out and you feel much better.
I did ask our minister to announce that Davita was pregnant in church, that everybody knew what was happening. I feel that God is not going to condemn anybody because you've made this decision to keep this baby or not keep this baby, or even to have sex when you're not married. It doesn't mean it's okay, but we all make mistakes and we have to live with them in the best way that we can.
But the whole sex before marriage thing, it's not really brought up much in our church. It's people's decisions if they want to. People don't go against you if you decide not to.
This is DeVita's favourite meal at the moment. Often tend to do whatever it is that DeVita wants. She is a bit spoiled. DeVita, did you want to come and take these plates in then, please?
DeVita is now spending most of her time at home with her mum.
I miss being at school for the fact that I don't get to see my friends as much. Some days during the week I go to the children's centre, but if I'm not doing anything then I just sit at home and watch telly. I spend most of my time with my mum at the moment.
It will happen.
I'm not scared yet, no. I will be on a water break.
As well as her mum, DeVita sees one other friend regularly, fellow mum-to-be, 17-year-old Tara.
I think I'm more excited, but yeah. When it happens I'll be like, oh, yeah, it's happening now.
Are you ever on your own?
I don't like to be now, do I?
No, I'm never too far away, so I can be available at any time, really.
With DeVita, she likes to know that I'm somewhere nearby that she can get in touch with me and that I can be there ASAP. So, you know, as long as she knows Mum's somewhere nearby, she's okay.
The biggest support in my life is my mum. Before I got pregnant, me and my mum were close, but not as close as we are now. We do everything together and I tell her absolutely everything.
In Fife, 16-year-old Becky is having problems adapting to life with a 14-month-old child.
Can you help her?
Do you want me to?
Come on then. Right, is Jamie's after here?
Without my mum, I probably wouldn't be able to survive as she helps me with everything.
You want to take your shirt off?
I prefer her to help me, because that way I don't get stressed and angry.
Where's mum gone? She disappeared at the crucial point again. And gets Nana to do it.
I remember her coming through to my room at about 3 o'clock one morning, throwing him on the bed, saying, you deal with him, I can't do this anymore. And he was less than 2 weeks old.
What are you wanting for your tea, George? I feel like a mum to all three of them, because Becky's always coming to me and saying, oh, mum, will you do that with him, and would you get him out of my hair? And it's just like I'm separating siblings rather than a mother and her son.
He's your boy. You feed him.
She's only just realising that he's here for the rest of her life and his life.
You happy?
No.
What do you mean, no? Not night, Kenzie.
Well, this time of the night, when Kenzie goes to bed, it's my time of the night. I can't wait till it comes. Because then we both get our rest and get peace and quiet from each other. Like, do what I want. Night, Kenzie.
Becky goes to college one afternoon a week. The rest of the time, she is either at home or helping her mum at work.
I have a small cleaning business, and Becky comes with me on days that are usually quite busy.
Bye, Kenzie. 2 minutes.
I go to work with my mum when I can be bothered, but half time she drags me out my bed because she doesn't want me on the couch all day.
So that Becky doesn't feel too overwhelmed, Kenzie goes to a childminder 5 days a week, paid for with tax credits and topped up by Tricia.
She gets paid for him if he's there or not, so wasting the money if he's not down there.
Would you like to have Kenzie during the day?
No, I like my peace and quiet.
During the week, she doesn't really have Kenzie very much because
she can't handle Kenzie very well on her own.
Kenzie would do her head in by the end of the week.
Over the past year, Becky has suffered from depression on and off. Mum Tricia wants to make sure she doesn't go down that path again.
You have to get you sorted. Because once you're sorted, you might be a little bit happier about yourself. You end up shouting at Kenzie and shouting at me and...
No, I don't.
If you had something to look forward to and to focus on, you might be a lot happier. No?
No.
But I'm not going to have you sitting on the settee doing absolutely nothing all day watching the telly. But you had big ideas when you were younger.
Like working on a pub in Spain.
You wanted to run your own bar. That's quite an ambition. If you can't do one thing, then you need to...
I want to be a midwife. I want to see it from the other end.
But if you want to be a midwife, great.
Becky missed her GCSEs because of her pregnancy and has to do a catch-up class before she can move on.
I'm feeling stressed, sad, angry. It's really, really boring. And it's like you've learnt that thing in high school and then you go up to the college and it's like, I've already learnt that. And they're like, well, you have to learn it again. I want to get stuck into midwifery. I want to be able to wake up in the morning and think, right, college today.
I just want to see you
happy.
Back in Morecambe, 15-year-old Davita is 37 weeks pregnant and going to see her midwife.
Thank you. Thank you, what a mum's for, Davita.
The father of Davita's baby is not around, so Mum Jackie goes with her to all her antenatal appointments.
So we'll just have a check. Oh, that head's well fixed down there now. The baby's in the right position for you to go into labour. That's brilliant. Good. OK.
Me and the baby's dad don't talk at all anymore. I didn't really know him at all when we first got together. It was just I wanted a boyfriend and he liked me, so...
It's big enough happen in the town now, can't it?
Who are you going to have with you when you go into labour?
My mum.
OK.
It was really upsetting knowing the baby's not going to have a dad around her and knowing that, like, my first child isn't going to be a proper family and things.
Put in fresh toilet rolls in toilets. They all seem to have been used up this week. It must have been a busy week.
Davita has a Saturday cleaning job at the church, but is finding it hard now she's so pregnant.
Because I've been having problems, like, walking and stuff. My mum does literally everything for me.
I think I'm a bit of a soft mum at times. Because she is the youngest, there isn't anybody else to take my full attention. So she gets all the attention at moment, mostly. Sometimes things feel a bit much and feels everything bogs you down, but then you have to get back up again and just get back in there. So, what are we going to do next?
I'm not good.
As well as doing Davita's job, Jackie has two jobs of her own to make ends meet.
I'm a school travel assistant, which I really enjoy doing. And then I also do paper deliveries. I just seem to have a very busy life. And it won't be long before it's going to get busier again with baby around. So we just get on and deal with things, get on with it.
Dada! Dada!
No, Dada's over here. Come here. Come here.
In Scotland, 16-year-old mum Becky has been single since her baby's dad died 8 months ago and is finding Kenzie a constant reminder of her ex.
Bye-bye.
Sometimes he shouts, Dad, as he's walking up the stairs. He does it all the time.
Come catch George.
And just randomly come up with Dad. And it's like, no, Kenzie, Dad's not here no more. He's singing with angels. And he just looks at me like, I'm confused.
He's the Iron Brew Man.
No, that's how you've got orange hair.
Today, Trisha's car has broken down, so they can't go to work or college, and Kenzie can't go to the childminder, so they're all stuck at home.
Becky, Kenzie's just going to stay here today.
Oh, no, he's not. Why is he staying here?
By 9 o'clock, Becky wants to get out of the house.
Well, I'll walk, still walk George to school.
Yeah, you can walk George to school if you want.
I won't be long. Right, bye.
Bye.
I don't normally take George to school, but I'm quite enjoying the day because I need out of the house. Right, bye.
Bye.
I'm in the house all the time. It's boring. Not to do in the house. When I lost Kenzie's dad, I wouldn't go near Kenzie, pick him up, bath him. I wouldn't do anything at all with him. I was mostly depressed because I didn't have, like, a dad figure for Kenzie.
Get in.
Now. I was scared that I would be a single parent, and I am a single parent.
I said no.
I like to have somebody to love me as well as my son. I want to be three of us.
My own little time with him was great. It was absolutely great.
Day more often then.
I can't, because I'm always working.
Oh, my dad always have them.
Yeah,
I worry about them constantly. I worry about her attitude towards him sometimes. There's quite a lot of resentment there, or what appears to be resentment. She doesn't want to be burdened with him. It's quite easy for her to walk away in the house.
I think it's going to be tea and bath and bed for you. Is that why Mum went out? See?
Mum, what's it this?
The next morning, things are looking up for Becky.
Can't wait.
Are you happy now?
Yeah.
It's all right then.
She's just got a text from a boy she met recently.
I'm going on a date. It's first proper date since Kenzie's been born. I'd love Kenzie to have, like, a stepdad, but a dad figure, somebody to look up to, and I just feel like he's going to be there. I think we're going to be happy.
In Morecambe, 15-year-old Davita is about to become a mum.
Yeah, it's a lot. And it is really uncomfortable.
It hasn't been an easy start to her labour.
Been here about 18 hours. I'm only 2 days over my due date. But because I've got, like, high blood pressure and protein, they've had to induce me.
In the absence of a boyfriend, Jackie is the natural stand-in.
It is a bit strange because I'm a mother, I'm baby's grandma, I'm also a partner. So I'm a bit of everything, really. But it's lovely to be going through all this with her, to be able to be there for her.
Right, do we want to close this curtain off then?
The birth isn't moving along as quickly as the doctors would like, so she is given a second induction pill internally.
I just need you to relax your bottom down. Yeah.
It's important to relax. It makes it easier. Oh, it gets it over with quicker.
Deep breath. Keep breathing like that. I've got to just get this in right behind the baby's head.
No, out. I know. Stun.
Davita has been at the hospital for 27 hours, and finally her contractions have started.
It hurts a lot. I'm tired.
Having very strong contractions now and very close together. So they're going to break her waters, which is going to be a big thing for her, but it means we're getting in the final stages. And she'll soon have her own little baby and this will all be over, won't it? I'm feeling very emotional at the moment. And I'm feeling very proud of her. She's fantastic. Yeah. You're wonderful.
I'm going to start to push now. She's wanting to push. So we'll soon have a baby for you to see.
An hour after her contractions start, Davita gives birth to a healthy little girl.
This is Kayla Marie, and she arrived at 4 minutes past 11.
Put the monitor on.
In Scotland, a month has gone by and Becky is still single after her date fell through.
Well, you're up for tonight then, Mrs. Am I going out anywhere?
No.
Mum Tricia is trying to lift Becky's spirits and help her bond with Kenzie, but at the moment she is refusing to take him out of the house on her own.
It must be boring for Kenzie being here every weekend as well. You know, it's the same boring routine for him as well as for you.
There's nothing to do.
You've got that play zone card. It gives you somewhere to go. Mm. Other than that, head towards the beach for the day.
Even beach is full of stones and litter.
What about further along?
Big rocks.
Is it? Do you not fancy the mother and baby group up at the church?
No way.
Do you know anybody that's been?
The other lassie that goes to college, she's